In macroeconomics, we study the economy of one country, then try to understand how two countries interact and trade, and hopefully understand the global economy. So today, we are going to study the circular flow of income. Let's make things really simple. Imagine we're alone on an isolated island. There's no government, no trade, no savings. I told you, it's simple. There's only firms and households. Firms provide households with goods and services. Out of thin air? Nah. Firms gotta get factors of production from households. It can be labor, land, capital, or face it, some of us in households are going to be entrepreneurs. So, entrepreneurship. For free? You wish! We don't get freebies from firms. We don't provide labor for free either. So there's money flowing in the opposite direction. Households gotta pay firms for the goods they get. Firms also gotta pay households in the form of wages, rents, interests, or profits. But this is a little weird. We don't spend everything we earn in real life. So let's add savings. Savings is money we don't spend. So there's money flowing out. Hey, savings don't just sit in banks. Banks invest in firms by lending to them. Cause firms need money to buy capital equipment or cover other costs of production. So there's investments flowing into the economy. Bravo! Awesome! But this is a little too simplified. So let's add government. Government buys stuff as well. So there's money flowing in. Government gets money from taxes. Taxes! So there's money flowing out. Cause for money we are paying as taxes, we cannot spend it. Lastly, countries interact with one another. Imagine this is an American economy. Let's add trade. America imports stuff. For example, America can import shoes from China. Shoes flow from China into America, and money spent on imports flows out of America into China. America exports too. America can produce software and export it to foreigners. Money then flows from foreign countries into America. This is America's export earnings. Investments, government spending, and export earnings are called injections, because money is flowing in. Savings, taxes, and import spending are called leakages or withdrawals, because money leaks out of the system. And hey, injections and leakages are sort of related. Investments come from savings. Government spending comes from taxes. America makes money from foreigners by exporting. But foreigners also make money from America when America imports. Wow, no wonder it's circular flow of income. It tells us roughly how an economy functions. How do we measure the size of an economy then? By measuring gross domestic product, or GDP. GDP is the total value of all final goods and services produced within the borders of a country during a given period. Why must it be final goods and services? If you like this video, remember to like and subscribe. Next up, measuring GDP, output approach.